Big Four parley moves behind the Iron Curtain to the Russian embassy in East Berlin, where security measures are stepped up and information, if any, is prettily given. As the conference enters its 10th session, it does so in surroundings that clearly bear the Soviet imprint. First to arrive is Francis Georges Bidault, who steadfastly refuses to quit the Western alliance. Anthony Eden, who outlined the Western plan for German unification, greets Russia's Molotov, chairman of the meeting. France, a key figure in the parley, has to date stood firm with the West. Looking resolute and grim, Secretary of State Dulles accuses the Russian delegation of delaying decision on the principal aims of the conference. As the meeting drags on, proposals and counterproposals are made without specific discussion of any. As things stand, hope for German unification dwindles to the vanishing point. The West remains unalterably opposed to a Soviet-proposed disarmament conference. The East and West remain poles apart.